Quinn can't please everyone, new.
You can't.
Yeah.
You can't.
You really can't.
Blowjobs every day would please everyone.
Not me.
Oh. Not me.
Just the guys. That's not everyone.
The girl gets just as much pleasure.
Oh, yeah. In the mouth? They get some of the best sensations.
Have you guys ever watched porn before? The girl, like, they is coming the whole time.
Because that's so realistic. It. That's right. So true. Yeah,
thank you.
They love it.
It's like they're eating like the juiciest steak ever.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, just don't chew.
Don't chew.
This is submitted by Steven from New York.
Ooh.
Oh, that's Steven from New York.
Have you ever sucked the shit out of a hot dog, though, and not really eaten it? So before, when I was innocent and I was a kid, I didn't know what dick sucking was. So like I had a hot dog, and then what my parents would do is they would grill the hot dog through like a chopstick. They would stick it in like
very innovative thing,
right?
Yeah.
And then so I was like, oh, I want to savor this hot dog, so I'm gonna try not to eat.
I'm trying to be on Joe's side 100%.
And I'm just like sucking the shit out of this.
Your parents
hot dog.
Are fucking calling all their friends, laughing at your pervy ass. Yeah,
if your parents had Instagram by then, and yeah. You looked back on their Instagram YouTube. Feed, it would have been on there.
You were like them, and you were like.
I was sucking the shit out of. I was trying to extract the salt just from that hot dog.
So then you must suck some good dick.
I might.
Yeah, you might would.
I might. To extract the soul.
Let's try it.
I could suck the fucking soul out of a punch.
I think guys can suck dick way better than girls can because we know what feels good.
Yeah.
No, Bart had his thinking hat on. And he was trying to reason with Joe. And he just couldn't make it work. Yeah. The square peg never fit in the round hole.
Yeah, I was like.
Vogue is being accused of racism after featuring an unlikely model in a recent Instagram.
The magazine?
Yes.
Unlikely model.
An unlikely model.
What? Did they pick a fat person or that's been done?
That's been done.
All right.
That's Dove's whole thing.
Tell me what's going on.
They picked this model.
Is she a Ku Klux Klan model?
Oh. From China?
That would be an unlikely.
That would be groundbreaking.
That would be.
So this is a Chinese model. She's 20 years old. Her name is Gao Xinghen. Sorry if I butchered it, which I probably did.
Probably did.
You said it very accurately.
Okay, thank you. I've been practicing my Chinese. So this is what they posted.
She looks like an American Girl doll.
She looks like a baby, but she's a woman.
I don't see it.
Do you have any other pictures of her?
Yes.
Oh, interesting.
She does have a very interesting look, though.
She has a very interesting look.
This doesn't look like the same, but it's the eyebrows. Eyebrows make a big
difference. I think her eyes are, oh yeah, you're right.
So she has small eyebrows, her eyes are really
further apart, right?
She has no bridge on her nose.
Sorry, no, it was just the first picture.
I know that feeling of not having a nose bridge.
Can you, is there any other pictures?
She looks young.
She's 20.
She looks fake.
So what are people, why is she racist?
Yeah, so what's
this is a caption. Would you like to read Vogue's caption?
Why did the caption say ching chang chong 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 chong?
Just hold on. As a model, Shizhen Gao brings a kind of singular appeal. The Shanghai-born textile design student at the London College of Fashion wound up in front of the camera by happenstance. Quote, I hadn't thought about modeling before moving to London, she says. She was scouted in the campus canteen on her lunch break. One of the photographers who spotted her was assisting at the London-based anti-agency, which prides itself on its iconoclastic taste. And it turned out to be the right match. Anti is a word that applies perhaps as a negative thing in some fields, but in terms of fashion and modeling, I think it challenges the norms of beauty and looks. Tap in the link in our bio to learn more.
What's wrong with that?
So the comments on this Vogue post, they said, first one said, this is racist. The other one said, if you really care about diversity, you should have Asians with all sorts of looks in your magazine, not just the stereotypical Asian-looking Asians. Another comment.
She doesn't look stereotypical. She doesn't look stereotypical.
I don't know any Chinese person that looks like her. She looks unique.
Me, as Chinese, every time fashion magazines only picks those so-called unique look to represent Asian aesthetics and duplicate an exotic illusion. And then rolling eyes, give me a break and thank you next. The next comment. God, please use some normal Chinese girl with normal look to represent Asian beauty. As Chinese, I don't get those fashion magazines' taste. Why the hell that you have to post some unique Asian models to mislead people? And then the last one says, I so get you, although in the caption it says iconoclastic. Or
they do that to white girls though.
No, so
like
so,
you know, so like there's models that look like aliens and they have weird looking eyes and face. And
I know exactly what you're talking about. Yeah.
And then that's what makes them beautiful though. Those highlighted
the high fashion models, like some of them have a big ass gap between the front teeth, but but that's what makes them beautiful.
So the rest of this comment says, the caption says, or challenges the norms of beauty and looks. All the unconventionally beautiful models are either Asian or Black, which is a rather strange thing given most models in the industry are white. Seems to me that Vogue is either condescendingly labeling itself as rebellious or simply trying to uglify other races.
She's just unique. I've just never seen anyone like her regardless of background.
It's so funny, from a picture, people project their own insecurities.
Yes.
It's just a photo.
Yeah, what they're really trying to say is, can you find someone as ugly as me? Is, I think, what they're
But here's the thing, Vogue's fucking up too, because they're doing this whole fucking thing where it's like, look at us, we're finding the most unique looking people. And then people have a right to debate that. Like, hey, I don't think this, you know what I'm saying? Like, like people, if you're gonna bring it up like that you're just so fucking woke and dope and shit, then people have a right to be like, hey, fuck you.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, they should have stayed pretentious. Mm-hmm. Just stick to your fucking guns.
Right.
What is their guns though? Because they're in fashion and they're...
It's hot people.
Vogue is known for hot?
Yeah, Vogue, I think Vogue has always been...
Victoria's Secret is hot, but Vogue has always been...
I thought that's what Vogue was.
Weird. Unique.
But high fashion has always been...
It's not sexual, it's just artistic.
Yes, and I thought that's what Vogue always has been.
It's always hot people in the cover, always.
I never thought that.
But you know, I personally don't know Vogue's like history well enough to understand like it has every Asian person, has every Vogue Asian Vogue model had too unique of a look that is like, oh, it's very Asian. Because in that case, maybe that is something to talk about, but I don't know its history well enough. Because it's like, you know, the qualities that are highlighted, are they, you know, considered to be within only Asian standards? Because I don't know.
Well, there is Vogue Asia, right? Or like Vogue Japan or Vogue whatever. And then they have their own standard, and then you see them covered in that.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't get why they feel that they need to represent that if that publication is being fair in that country.
Mm-hmm. Well, this also comes after a recent thing also. So Zara was being accused by Chinese netizens of uglifying China for using photographs of a freckled Chinese model without Photoshop or makeup, saying like, how dare you use her, what's wrong with her, to represent Chinese people. That's what a lot of people were commenting.
And it goes back to talking about insecurities and projecting their own insecurities.
I think the freckles is what makes her dope. I think if you took it out, then she would just look like any other like.
And that's what the Chinese netizens are arguing or like complaining about, like make her look like all of us.
Well, that's the cultural standard of beauty, right? Yeah. So in Asia, since it's collective, what they want to do is not stick out too much. Whereas out here, it's more about what makes you unique. Yeah. So the way we view this beauty is, oh, those freckles on Asian girls, unique. She has a beautiful face, great features, right? Over there, they're like, why are you shaming us, man? Like, why do you have to get the ugliest Asian girl? Yeah,
but is this an ad? Is this an ad for here?
Zara? No, it was an ad.
So fucking mean.
Why did you guys have to get
the ugliest Asian girl? I mean, you're right.
That's basically what
they're saying. You're right, that is what they're saying. You're exactly right. It's, so they're being mean, though, and they don't know it.
They're being fucking mean.
Yeah. And what they don't understand is, like, the how they hate freckles over there is reflected in their hatred of their own culture, right? Because what they want is bleached white skin, and that's not always a thing for like all Asian countries and all Asian people.
Yeah.
And so it's like their hatred of their own culture being reflected in like being celebrated and in unique in our culture. But I think it's just this mixture of like not understanding it.
I think it's always been a part of Asian culture to like the lightest of skin because it meant royalty. Yeah. So I don't think it's the whole I want to be white thing.
That powder white skin?
Right. Stuff? It's looking like a painted white.
Because that means you've never done any blue collar work. You've never been on the farm or anything. You've always been inside of a palace.
So it means
that's
where
a lot of those statues are. Like they're all that porcelain white.
That's what beauty is. It's because you're not working. You're pure or whatever. You're not in the sun. So that's where it stems from, but then that's just fucking weird, man. It's like evolved.
I wouldn't know if I would call it weird for another country. I would just, I just feel sad where I'm like, damn, like you're getting shunned for being unique, you know, for standing out. But at the same time, I'm like, but that's just their culture. Like, I can't be like, that's fucked up, you know?
It's funny because the model just gets burned to a crisp.
Yeah, she just doing, she's just taking photos.
She's like, cool, I got hired for this gig. How cool is that? And then it's like, destruction.
I think that's what's fucked up.
Yeah, she's just that a student, right? A textile student, and she just gets fucking roasted to the ground.
By a community of people, wrecked.
Her own community.
Her own people.
Her own community.
She's like, fuck, I'll just stick to school then, goddamn.
It's like, damn, you had to get the ugliest Chinese girl. What the fuck? Yeah. And she's like, what the fuck, man?
She's like, I didn't even want to be a model.
People need to think about that, though, because like, a lot of this woke culture shit, they target individuals, like, and they bend their idea through it, and then fucking destroys a human being on the way.
Yeah. You
know? Instead of celebrating, good job, a minority is in vogue.
But it's not good enough because, you know, she's not she's enough. Like too, well, you gotta get the light skin Asian. What about the dark skin Asian? What about this Asian?
Yeah, you're never gonna get
it's
it.
It's like, shut the fuck up.
Dude, it's like
up.
That, it's like that Will Smith thing where he's doing, he's being Venus and Serena Williams' dad he's in the movie, but he's not black enough. It's like, what the fuck, bro? It's like, Jesus. It's like, you need to have a dark skinned enough actor to match the actual dad. It's like, okay.
Would he be in trouble if he darkened his skin? With makeup?
Good question.
In this day and age, maybe.
It's really interesting.
You could, maybe it's illegal for a black guy to do blackface in this age. Right. It's pretty crazy.